and welcome to SkyFactory 4. My name is Whisperfire, and at this moment in our progress, we need snow and plastic. The reason why that we need snow is so that we can finish the animal croppings to get an adult penguin and a polar bear seed. But in order to get snow, we're going to need to go into Industrial Foregoing to get a froster. But this requires plastic. So we need to dig into the latex processing unit and the tree fluid extractor. So basically, we are going into Industrial Foregoing. So I got everything all prepped. So let's go ahead and go to our bookmarks, and we're going to get a tree fluid extractor. We're going to need about 5 gears, I believe. So, we're going to need this. So, we got ourselves a tree fluid extractor, and we're going to get 4 latex processing units. What do we need? We need a machine case. So, we're going to need 4 machine cases, like so. Oh, what am I missing? Oh, furnaces. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Do we need 4? Yeah, I think we need 4. Okay, and we already got a block placer from Cyclic. We made this when we were trying to make our lava generator, but we made the wrong block, so that was a derp on my part. And also, we're going to need an infinite water source, since the sinks from cooking with blockheads is disabled. So, I've devised a strategy for this task. So we're going to need 2 cauldrons, and we're going to make 2 ender tanks. Okay, now we're going to need some blue dye, if I can type blue. So we're going to grab some of this, and we're going to grab some diamonds. All right, because we're on the server, we need to tag our tanks. So we need to click it with a diamond so that it is bound to us. And we're going to color code it. We're going to color code it light blue. Like that. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and break these tanks. And we're going to set up our infinite water source first. So we got something right over here. I just set it up, and it looks like we're going to need some torches. So let me go ahead, grab some torches. Let's put this back. Okay. And torch. And we're going to need a block. So I'll just grab a white wool. Okay. So we'll go ahead, hit F7. All right. That's where the light goes. All right. That should take care of it. Now we're going to take this white wool, and we're going to take this fluid extraction cable, place it right there. And you seen how it sucks up water? Okay, then we just go ahead and put it in this tank. And you seen how it's sucking it up? This is not an infinite water source, but it will do. Yeah, it will do. So, let's see. Where are we going to put the fluid extraction stuff? Okay, so let's go ahead, grab some blocks. So I'm going to just grab some wool. All right. I'm going to grab some wool just for some building blocks. And basically, we're going to have our block placer facing upward. Let's see, how are we going to plan this? All right, so if we place that there and this there, one more, and just for good measure, we'll just put that there to keep mobs from spawning. All right. Now we're going to need to break this one block. Okay, I got it. All right. We're going to take the block placer. All right. Fly a little bit. Whoop. And bam. There. It's facing down. All right. Let's get out of here. So this is going to be our block placer. We're going to take that and place this right here. And come on, come on. All right, and we could probably put another lamp over here. Okay, so let's go ahead and take a look. This one looks like it does not require power. Now, for the fluid, for the latex, oh no, we dirt, didn't we? We only need one latex processing unit and four tree fluid extractors. I am such genius. Yeah, I am such a dirt. We'll go ahead and place that there. And let's, for now, yeah, I definitely derped. Okay, so we're going to need the tree fluid extractor. So we're going to need three more furnaces and three more gears. All right. There, that should do it. All right, now for the wood, oak wood is good, but it had, but mineral wood has a better kick to it. So we're going to go ahead and use mineral wood to extract our latex, and I think that's enough. Okay, so let's see how these tree fluid extractors work. So I'm going to place it here. And it's facing the wrong way. Okay, so we'll just place that there, place that there, place this here, and okay, and it's placing the wood. All right, so we'll just go ahead and fill it up. And the tree fluid extractor it doesn't need power. Okay, that makes things easier. All right, so we'll go ahead and do that. And we got some extraction cables. So let's see, how are we going to do this? I know. We'll go ahead and pipe it through the bottom so that the wiring looks a little bit nicer. All right, so we'll just go ahead and break these blocks. Yeah. We'll just do our wiring from the bottom. I think that is for the best. All right, and trying to get the pattern right. Okay, and this one. All right, where is our tree latex processing unit? That's going to be right about here. Nice, that is wonderful. All right, so we'll go ahead, take these pipes, all right, and take this fluid cable. So we're going to need to take it down by one. All right, shift and hold to space so that we can get stable. And we will go ahead and place that right up in there. Okay. And let's take a look. This does not have any latex just yet, but we're going to need power. We're going to need a GPS unit, and we need to supply it with water. So we're going to need another extraction cable. So we're going to need a dropper and a weighted pressure plate there. Yeah, cyclic makes things easy. Okay, so we'll go ahead and put this away for now, and I don't think we're going to need any more of this. No. Okay. Oh yes, we are going to need liquid. It's called fluid. All right, so we're still going to need that, and we're going to need a GPS. A GPS doohickey. All right, we've got ourselves a GPS marker. Doopa 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 doop. Okay, that is not. That is kind of bugged. All right, I'll get another bucket of water. All right, so we got another energy transfer node, and we'll place it in there. All right, and you know what? I don't want wiring right here. No, I don't think I want wiring. So this is getting power. And is that extracting latex? It looks like it is, but it's not going into the processor. Okay. We may need to go into another mod for piping. All right. So let's go ahead and collect these. Oh, okay. So right now we're doing a little bit of troubleshooting. All right, but we are going to collect these because these are valuable. Okay, so it looks like the cyclic is not doing what it should do. Okay, so it's getting the liquid latex. Let's look into an alternative way of getting fluid. But first, alright, so we're gonna need a bucket. Okay, got ourselves a bucket. And we're gonna need that tank because I don't want to do some of that wiring. Okay, let's see if we can fix it. Okay, that's fixed. Alright, let's put the tank here. And let's put that there. Alright, so that is getting fluid. Oh, it is working. It is working. Oh, I see. I see, says the blind man, peeing in the wind. It's all coming back to me now. So this did work. Okay, so we'll go ahead and fix up the wiring like that and go over and like this. Yeah, that should do it. All right, let's see. How is this going to process? Okay, we'll sit here and let that process for a moment. And basically, yeah, we're going to AFK and wait for it to do its magic. Okay, so we got ourselves a 9 stacks of tiny rubber. So I'm gonna go ahead and take this item extraction cable so that it will start putting it into there. And I think that's enough plastic to do what we need to do. So let's go ahead and take all of this tiny dry rubber from Industrial Foregoing, because we're going to make something really cool. We're going to make some dried rubber, and that should be a stack. And we're going to place it in our upgraded furnaces. And look at that. We got ourselves some plastic. Oh yeah. Okay, so we need the froster. So we're going to need another machine case. That is no problem. We're going to need a gold gear. Alright, and we're going to need some buckets. Alright, so we're going to need 2 buckets. That ought to do it. Alright, I don't want to break that water source just yet. And we'll toss it in there, and that should be it. Okay, we're going to need to place that other bucket. And we got ourselves the froster. Alright, let's see what this does. Alright, it needs power, it needs water. But let's take a look. For snow, we're going to need, let's take a look, machine outputs defroster. Okay, so that's what we need. All right, where to put it? Where to put it? Let's grab a GPS. Okay, so GPS and bam. All right. Got ourselves a GPS. Go ahead, clear that out. And let's see, where do we want it? We're going to need another fluid extraction cable, I think. Yeah. Okay. So, fluid extraction cable. Let's take a look. It's going to need another dropper and another pressure plate. And that should do it. Okay. I don't know, maybe we can compact everything together here. So let's put that there. And the fluid extraction there. Okay. And we right click. And we put it into our energy transfer node. Is that going to get us some snow? Okay. How do we make snow? Alright, so it's a machine output from Industrial Foregoing, but it doesn't say what we need to put. So let's take a look. It's Loot Fabricator, Statue Loot, Machine Output, Froster. Okay. Let's see. Energy items, water output, fluid containers. Do we hit play? No, we hit pause. We're missing something. We're definitely missing something. Let me look this up and see if we were on the right track. Okay, I think I figured it out. I was looking at the Industrial Foregoing manual, which you craft by putting a log and paper, any log with a sheet of paper. And we got the user manual. So if you sneak right click, it says defroster allows you to create cold substances by spinning the supplied water at very fast speeds and reducing the temperature using power. That didn't say much, but I noticed these buttons here. So if I hit that and I hit that, I can choose what to produce. So we got ourselves some ice, and we're going to get ourselves some snow. All right. So we'll have that make some snow. And let's go ahead and go into the animal crops. Animal crops, and let's take a look. Polar bear. All right, we need fish. Oh boy. Do we have any fish? Will salmon work? Don't know. Will clownfish work? I don't know. Otherwise, we probably have to go fishing again. Alright, because I just made everything into, I cooked it and made it into leather. So, let's see if this works. Alright, we're gonna need a block of snow. Alright. So, just grab that, and voila, we got ourselves some snow. Alright, and we'll pop that. Please, can we get by with just that? No. Oh, boo, and I just used up all of that fish. Okay. For the Adele penguin seeds. That one, where was that? We needed, oh, we need polar bear seeds. Okay, we'll keep that clownfish, we'll keep that ice. You know what? I think Jam Doggy has some fish. I don't think he'll mind if we snag two. So we're going to sneak on over to Jam Doggy's base. Alright, hit F7. Alright, where's his fish doohickey? He had a fisher right over here. Alright. Oh, he has it turned off. Oh, he has it in here. Okay. What do you know? We got the fish that we need. I'll just drop that in there. Teehee. Okay, so we're just getting that. Okay, go through the portal hub and let's take a look what's here. Oh, hey, free skulls. You know what? We need this. We need this to do some farming for nether stars later. I'm working on another side project. Okay, so we need to make 2 polar bear seeds because the polar bear seeds are being made to make the Adele penguin. So, we've got 2 polar bear and 1 Adele. Boom! We got ourselves that advancement. Check that out. We got that done. Woohoo! Alright, so let's grab a chest. And we'll put that there. So we got all of our animal seeds done. That is a major load off. Okay, let me explain what I am doing next. I've been working on the Supremium armor. Even though it's not an advancement, I still want it because it gives creative flight. And the only thing that's hanging us up is the Supremium armor core. We just got a stack of skulls. Next episode, we're going to kill the Wither about 4 times to get the materials that we need to finish this armor set. And while I'm thinking about it, I want to make that powered anvil so that we could repair our items. So let's go ahead and make that. And we got the enchanting. And we got ourselves a powered anvil. Alright, that... What you basically do is you put equipment into the anvil like this. Well, I don't know about tinkers, but other stuff. And it will repair the equipment at the expense of power. Okay, so we got an achievement done. We got a project done. We got another project well underway. We started Industrial Foregoing, and we got a supply of plastic. So I'm going to go ahead and wrap it up here. Next episode, we're going to go on a new project where we fight the Wither so that we can make some Supremium armor. So I hope you enjoyed this episode. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share. This has been Whisperfire, and I wish you an awesome day. Oh yeah.